Now I read a quotation from Swami Vivekananda's lecture. This universe has not been created by any extra cosmic god, nor is it the work of any outside genius. It is self-creating, self-dissolving, self-manifesting. One infinite existence, the Brahman, Tattvamasi, that thou art. Compare it. This universe has not been created by any extra cosmic god, nor is it the work of any outside genius. It is self-creating, self-dissolving, self-manifesting, says Swami Vivekananda. So long as the universe had a beginning, we could suppose it had a creator. But if the universe is really completely self-contained, having no boundary or edge, it would have neither beginning nor end. And it would simply be, what place then for a creator? That is Stephen Hawking. How parallel the words are. Now, I am not saying that Swami Vivekananda knew about the M theory, or Swami Vivekananda knew about the string theory, or he knew about the quantum mechanics. No. What I am saying is, the Advaita philosophy, the Advaita Darshana, it gives Swami Vivekananda a vision that can resonate across space and time with the cosmic vision that the science reveals. Now, if a student is well versed with Advaita through the curriculum, and if he is taking physics, and if he is studying Stephen Hawking, or if he is studying any of the cosmological theories, then how easy it will be for him to get it inside his being. And then he can move forward. He can ask fresh questions. He can look at the world in a fresh way. And he can create fresh theories. And India becomes a real scientific community. It can realize its human potential. Now we are wasting the human potential, because in the name of secularism, we are not teaching our own Indic knowledge systems to our children.